be operational.
The Banished are planning to fire this ring.
We need help, not heroics.
We protect humanity, whatever the cost.
Something pushed back.
You are not the future.
What's going on, everyone? The Great Talent here, and today we're going to talk about Halo Infinite, reviewed on the Xbox Series X. Well, folks, I finally did it. I finally wrapped up the campaign of Halo Infinite, and let me tell you, folks, it was not only the longest Halo game, clocking in at a little over 20 hours after doing almost everything on the map, but it was the most immersive Halo experience I've ever had in my life. But that's a good and a bad thing, in a sense, because what it does with the gameplay, what greatness that comes with gameplay, sacrifices with the narrative, and we'll get to that in a little bit. But Halo Infinite, like I said, has to be the most immersive game to date, and has to be the most tweaked and polished performance of it to back it up. By adding something as simple as a grappling hook, folks, a fucking grappling hook, it's amazing what one piece of equipment can do, can utilize, and allows the Master Chief to have such a wide array of mobility. And, like, it truly opens up the playground for what you can do in this semi-open world, like, Halo game. You can grapple onto any object, any environment, as well as, you can grapple onto fucking enemies if you want. And you can upgrade the grappling hook to, like, freeze them into place and, like, shock them, and then you can just fucking run up and just fucking bitch smack them with the melee attack. It's fucking crazy. Other than that, you can grapple onto vehicles, too, so you can, like, hijack a Banshee, one of the flying vehicles, in mid-flight, get it and then fucking kick the owner out and then fucking take it and control of it. Also, you can hijack vehicles on the ground. It's so cool, so immersive. And to top it off, if you're like in a jam and you see you're running out of ammo, let's say, for example, and like you see a weapon over in the corner of your eye and you're in enough range to grapple to it, you can grapple the weapon, grid it into your arsenal and fucking exchange it. It literally opens up the game in such a way, folks, that it really makes you feel like you are a cybernetic Batman, to be honest. It's so fucking cool, that grappling hook. Cannot stress that enough. Grapple hooks are such a great tool in any game that requires traversal such as this, and it's utilized really well here. What else can I say? With also that being said, too, you also get other equipment upgrades besides the grappling hook. You get three other upgrades to at your disposal, which are super useful, such as portable shield that you can deploy, electrical shield that you can deploy that and use as cover, but at the same time you can shoot through it to kill enemies, that's the first time it's ever been done in a Halo game. It's very useful, because other Halo games was like the bubble shield, you couldn't shoot through it, you could just use it for defense, not offense. This is kind of a two-way radio. It's pretty cool, but actually you can shoot out, but you can't shoot into the shield. That's something to be noted of, but it's pretty definitely very useful tool. Also, you get a motion detector as well. You pop that in and you can see any invisible enemies or enemies that are not popping up on your radar, so you can kind of zone in on them and zero in on them, which is pretty great. Helps during some boss fights. As well as a thruster ability, which you can quick dash in multiple succession, is the more you upgrade the equipment, to help you get out of jam, get out of dodge quick, and it comes in really handy during the final series of boss fights as well. Also, speaking of boss fights, this is the first in a Halo series that you can actually have boss fights. You can, like, there were minor bosses very little. Like, I think Halo 2 was the only one that had a real boss. Other than that, it was just really big battles. They have shields and health bars now, these boss fights, and it was definitely a refreshing change of pace to encounter mini bosses, for example, as like little targets you gotta take down of this Banished. They're called the new villains, they're called the Banished. You gotta find these key targets, these mini bosses, and take them out across the map, and I thought that was really a really cool little feature to have. You know, I really did enjoy the mission structure here more than I actually initially thought I was going to. Usually Halo has a very linear-based mission structure, meaning it's like, all right, level one, mission two, and they're separated. And you can replay them anytime you want. You see that there's positives and negatives to each instance, folks. See, you cannot replay any story mission in Halo Infinite, but on the bright side of things, unfortunately, it's so immersive that you can just keep encountering battles and things that to do on the map that just don't run out. And if they do, you could just reset and start a new game and then do it all over again. I wish they kind of would add the ability to replay missions or whatever, but that's neither here nor there. Maybe they'll do that within a future patch, who knows. But with that being said, though, like I said, I also enjoyed, like I said, collecting and cleaning up most of the miscellaneous objectives around, along the map, minus a few that were kind of missing. Like, I didn't get all of the audio logs because it's like almost impossible. They don't really tell you where they all are, and they're so tiny you can barely see them unless you scan. You have a scanning ability where it allows you to detect things, and it's so even hard to scan. It could be, like verticality plays a big role in this game, and it's so much different, like topography, like landscapes, mountains, and ranges, and whatnot. It's just, it's massive in terms of depth, like scaling, not as like vertically massive, not horizontal. You know what I mean? It's not, it's a lot of layers to the game because you can grapple or whatever, but to do that is like finding a needle in a haystack, folks. But anyway, again, with that being said, I also want to point out too that you can find all these little collectibles, and the gunplay I want to mention too is seriously meaty this time around, folks. The gunplay, each shot feels as intentional as the last and as precise, as leaving you with feeling a robust sense of like precision and intent the more you shoot these weapons. And it's just a robust feeling of just like intentionality. It's so, so robust. And the new electric and hard light weapons, such as the shock rifle, are pretty neat as well to use. They come in like, there's like the shock rifle now that you can zoom in on. It's pretty cool. There's a cinder shot, like fucking disintegrate enemies and whatnot. A lot of new weapons are pretty cool. I do miss the original shotgun. They upgraded it to the, where they give you the brute shotgun now, which is okay, but I kind of miss the old one. Maybe they'll add it on later on. I've heard they might. In addition to the open world map, you can now collect valor points. The more you like do, like you can rescue Marines, take over bases and whatnot, drop points and whatever you gain, take down targets, you get valor points. And the more valor points you get, the more aggregated total of valor points you get, the more you unlock at your operating bases. So you can unlock like new vehicles, Marines, weapons, arsenals and stuff like that, and so on and so forth. And also you can collect Spartan cores, they're called, around the map. Spartan cores using for upgrade your abilities like your grappling hook, your shield, your motion detector, thruster, and a barrier. So it's pretty definitely useful. I enjoy collecting them. It added a sense, another layer that to the Halo games that it never had. And you were never able to upgrade any of the Master Chief's abilities at all in any Halo game other than this one. So this is definitely a first and a much needed evolving of the series, so to speak. And the story, though, in regards to the story, it does start off a little wonky, but it kind of ends like it pulls it all together, coming full circle in the end, and a little bit of a sense of callback to the first two Halo games, which is pretty cool. And it actually insinuates another Halo game at the end. It was kind of ended on like a little bit of a cliffhanger, quote unquote. And I honestly thought they were done after this, so I thought the title Infinite was like, all right, it just goes on round and round and round. It just never, where it stops, nobody knows. But to be honest, folks, I really thought that it was going to be ending here, but who knows the word end in Hollywood or the video game industry? No, nobody knows that word at the end. Nobody knows finality anymore. Nothing is sacred. Look, fucking Matrix Resurrections just came back. Well, that shit was over with. I mean, shit. And lastly, folks, the multiplayer section feels just as good as it did in the Halo 3 days. It is definitely better than Halo 5 and 4. Isn't better than Halo 2 or 3, but it's within the ballpark of Halo 2 and 3. The only thing that's missing is if they could add more various modes such as Griffball, I may never leave my couch, because right now it's really fun. I'm really good at it. You know, I don't want to toot my own horn, but I'm one of the few things in this world I'm really good at, folks, and Halo is one of them. So come at me, bro. But other than that, the downsides of this game, a little bit of cons here. I found numerous glitches throughout many of my times playing this game. A lot of crashes, a lot of bugs, a lot of game-breaking bugs, too, that had to be, thankfully, were reset, help resolve by resetting the app. Like, I ran into a really bad glitch where I kind of just, my guns just stopped shooting. And I was like, oh my god, my right trigger, I thought my controller was broke. But I resetted the app and I was able to shoot again. And I'm like, wow, that was kind of scary. At pivotal moments, I couldn't shoot my weapon. I couldn't even zoom in. It was terrifying. But I hope they patch that later on down the line. What else I did not like? I did not like, besides the glitches, that the game is lacking one mode that is pivotal, crucial in the Halo games, that's been with the Halo game since its inception, since I first started playing it when I was 14 years old back in 2001, and that is the ability to do campaign cooperative mode. Where the hell is that, man? Where the fuck is it, guys and gals out there? Where is it? The one staple of the series. But it is very sorely missed here, especially in a more open world like environment and biomes like this, where it kind of gets really lonely just trekking about by yourself at times. And also, besides the Master Chief, the new Cortana, and this, random Marine, there really is no other protagonist in the game other than the heavy-breathing Brute Betty and his ragtag crew. But alas, folks, alas, I must say, if, without those negativities aside, it is, other than all these little minor nitpicks here and there, it is a great Halo experience, only hindered by its lack of cooperative play, numerous glitches, and lack of a more focus on a deeper narrative with a truly, but that also comes coupled with a truly immersive gameplay and multiplayer experience that will be with us for a very long time. However, with that being said, though, the multiplayer does need a little bit of tweaking, folks. It needs a little bit of tweaking, and I'll tell you why. There's one worry of mine that that kind of worries me, and it kind of frightens me a little bit, because there's the multiplayer is free, okay? It's completely free to play, even if you don't have a copy of Halo Infinite at all. It's free. It's like Fortnite. It's completely free to play. My concern is that they're going to make you jump through hoops and grind and grind and grind like free-to-play games do. Remember, folks, they're not free-to-play. They are fee to pay, like you're paying a fee. So keep that in mind. They said they're going to fix it. I think that's a bunch of yanking bullshit. We'll see what happens. But other than that, folks, the campaign is worth the full price of admission. If you don't want to pay $60 for it, just fucking get it. It's on Game Pass. It's included with the $10 or $15 a month membership, whatever tier you're at. So go for it, folks. With that being said, if I had to score Halo Infinite on a scale of 1 to 10, I would give it an 8 out of 10. It's a great game. Great Halo game. Is it the best Halo game? No. Is it the worst? Far from it. But it is a very, very rewarding, enjoyable experience that I can highly and safely recommend from the great talent's heart and soul. So, again, that being said, that is my review of Halo Infinite. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will catch you everybody next time. Thanks, as always, for stopping by, and have a happy, healthy, and safe New Year.